Well, we've gone to hot, then cold, then back to hot, then back to cold. It seems like Mother Nature can't make up her mind this winter, and that roller coaster of temperatures continues this week. Right now, we're dealing with colder temperatures after that cold front came through. We're seeing a live look earlier, what we had right around 4:30 at the Lake Club in Poland. A few rain showers, even some snow mixing in. But right now, we are seeing dry conditions, but that will change as the night goes on tonight. Also, we're seeing a live look over downtown Youngstown currently. We took a still off of our SkyCam. You can see the flags in the picture here on the YSU campus. Still pretty windy out there. The windy conditions are going to continue for tonight, even into tomorrow morning. We're seeing current wind speeds right around 15 miles an hour, and you can see throughout the entire region, some strong winds throughout the area. Not expecting anything too strong, even nothing near severe strength. But again, it's going to make those colder temperatures feel even colder for the rest of tonight. We're looking at those clouds and radar. Now, all that rain that you see over by the East Coast, those produce some thunderstorms, which is the late end of what we saw as the storms moved past last night. But right now, we're dealing currently with the snow, and we will continue to deal with the snow as we get on to the later parts overnight. Right now, you're seeing, again, the stronger squalls starting to move into Trumbull, even Mahoning counties. We're not expecting anything too much in the form of accumulation. You might wake up to a light dusting, maybe some small accumulations, less than a quarter of an inch in spots. Nothing too significant for tonight. Temperature-wise, we're looking at the mid-20s for most of the area. At the official temperature, 27 at the airport, even in Lawrence County, still feeling into the upper 20s. Now, all of us are going to drop back down into the mid to lower 20s, which is why we're seeing that temperature trend change of 40 degrees from where we were yesterday. So that high of 75 degrees we saw yesterday, we're not going to hit that again anytime soon, even though we have 60s back in our 7-day forecast. Before we get there, though, we're looking at a cold start tomorrow, right around the mid-20s. Those snow showers will taper off as we get towards tomorrow morning, and then we can see those temperatures begin to rise, but not by too much. Highs only into the upper 30s for Sunday, and then as we get into Monday, those freezing temperatures will return by tomorrow morning. We're starting the day off freezing, but we're going to get back into the 40s as we get into Monday evening. Well, we are also expecting a little bit of rain as we get into our later end on Monday night, right around 9:30. Before we get there, we're looking at a low right around 24 degrees, a chance of snow, but not much, less than an inch. And then as we go for tomorrow, high right around 40 degrees, partly sunny skies by the afternoon, and those sunny skies will continue as we get into Monday evening, as we see that rain chance begin to develop back into the area. Tuesday, that rain more likely as we get into Wednesday, highs back into the low 60s. And then we're going to see a cold front come through between Wednesday and Thursday. Those colder temperatures will return. So will the chance for snow.